Hey folks, so OpenAI released some new tools today for building agents, and there are a few interesting things in there. I think the first is the updated API. So in addition to the chat completions API, there is now a responses API, and pretty much it takes in the new parameter, which is tools. But the more important thing is that they have put out an open source MIT licensed agent SDK, and that's kind of what I'll be talking about in this video. So in this video, I'll do about three things. The first is that I'll walk through a hello world example where we will sort of look through implementing a simple agent using the AutoGen API as well as the OpenAI agent SDK, sort of compare it in terms of lines of code and general API structure. Next, I'll walk through some of the examples that are provided by the OpenAI documentation. Then I'll finalize sort of looking at what the library is pretty good at, what it sort of ships with, and how it compares, what's missing compared to a more mature framework like AutoGen. Let's get started. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and compare the AutoGen Agent Chat API with the OpenAI Agent SDK. And to do that, I have gone ahead and implemented the basic Hello World agent example. And so what we want here is a simple agent, has access to a model client and has access to a single tool, a calculator tool. So let's sort of look at what that looks like on both frameworks. And so on the left, we have the AutoGen Agent Chat API. And one thing I'll say off the bat is that it's really, really similar. And it's kind of exciting and interesting to see that like new frameworks coming up, like the OpenAI Agents SDK, is sort of following some of the design patterns that we have proposed in AutoGen. So the first thing is you have your installation for the OpenAI agent SDK. It's pip install OpenAI agent, and so this is the installation for AutoGen. And then there are a bunch of imports here. We can skip that for now. The next important similarity is that to define a tool, essentially you can define a Python function, and the same thing here in the OpenAI SDK, you define a Python function. And I think the only difference is that you have to annotate it with a function tool decorator. Next, we move to the main section of the code. Here in AutoGen Agent Chat, we simply define a model client, and we have something called the OpenAI Chat Completion Client. We define a termination condition. So this is a set of conditions that when met, the entire run or the workflow sort of is terminated. Here we say if we have a maximum of 10 messages or any agent returns with the text terminate. And then we define something called an assistant agent. And then we give the assistant agent a name, which is assistant. We give the model client, and we give it tools. And the tools here is actually calculator. And then we put it into a round robin chat container, and then we sort of call team.run. Very, very similar stuff with the OpenAI Agent SDK. Here we define the model client. They have something called the OpenAI chat completions model. So very similar to the chat completions client here. Specify a model, very, very similar here. Next, they have an abstraction called an agent. Very, very similar to the assistant agent in AutoGen. There's instructions here. The equivalent here will be a system message. There's tools, the exact same thing here. And then there's a model, the exact same thing here. Model client, the model client, we have model here. And here, as opposed to having an actual preset for running container that sort of determines how each of the agents are called, executed, you just have a generic runner class, and they say runner.run, they give it an assistant agent, and then here's the task. And the results are really, really similar. So if we look at the results here, with agent chat, we just have a bit of formatting here, and with the OpenAI agents SDK, we just have the exact same result. Okay, so now that we have compared the basic structures of the OpenAI SDK compared with AutoGen Agent Chat API, let's take a look at some of the interesting things they have in the documentation over here. Of course, we've gone through how an agent is defined. So you have a name, you have the instructions, and the parallel to AutoGen is a system message for instructions. In addition, very similar to AutoGen, you can define multiple agents. And then here they have like some sort of idea of handoffs. And so here for this agent called the triage agent, the instruction is that you determine which agent to use based on the user's homework question. And there's a concept of handoffs. And so these are all the agents that this agent can sort of like delegate control to as a task progresses. And it's really, really similar to the swarm abstraction in AutoGen. And so if you go to the AutoGen version 0.4 documentation, there's actually an agent team container called swarm, and very, very similar. You can again define a model client. In this case, define a travel agent, a flight refunder, that sort of thing. And then you can define the a swarm team and put in this agent into this swarm team container. And importantly, you can define handoffs. And so for example, in this case, the flight refunder agent is able to hand off to a travel agent or to a user. And in this case, the travel agent is able to hand off to a flight refunder or a user. So very, very similar, very, very interesting overlap here. Let's keep going. So they also have the idea of guardrails, and essentially you can just think of them as functions that evaluate to some Boolean true or false, and essentially you can think of it as breakpoints. And so they have the concept of output types, and so I think underneath this just uses the structured output capabilities, and the idea is that it ensures that we can cast whatever comes out of the agent to a specific output type. And so, for example, with this agent, the core task is to check if the user is asking about homework, and the output is supposed to sort of evaluate or be cast into a data structure with two fields, is homework and reasoning. And the idea is that, let's say, assuming we were running a function that had some text and it came to this agent, this agent might respond with a structure that looks like this. And then based on that, here there's a concept of a tripwire triggered, and I think this just holds to terminate the entire conversation. And here it just says, you know, if for any reason the result that comes back is actually a homework, then the entire thing sort of shuts down. And in some way, this is similar to the idea of termination conditions in AutoGen. And so, for example, we can sort of terminate a conversation if a response from an agent contains a specific text. But there's a lot more interesting things you could do with AutoGen. For example, terminate based on total number of turns, terminate based on token usage or budget, terminate based on timeout, terminate based on an external condition. But I think the idea of guardrails sort of are similar to the idea of termination conditions. Guardrails and tripwires are similar to the idea of termination conditions in AutoGen. And in their final example, here's what they sort of show. There's the idea of a guardrail agent, a math tutor agent, a history tutor agent. And then they define this homework guardrail. And then they define a triage agent. That's sort of the input point. And at any point, this triage agent can sort of hand off to either the history tutor agent or the math tutor agent. But while it does so, it also, I guess whatever input it gets, it passes that through the guardrail function first of all. And so in this case, I have run this code. If you did ask who was the first president of the United States, it does evaluate to true as homework and the entire thing just shuts down. Okay, so what are the other interesting things they have in the library? I think tracing. Tracing is really interesting. I think this is sort of expected for any LLM kind of library. And so they have like trace import, and then you can sort of wrap that as context around your workflow, and all of that gets sort of logged to the OpenAI to the OpenAI server, actually OpenAI servers. For AutoGen, we sort of explore tracing a bit more with a lot more freedom. So for example, OpenTelemetry, we use OpenTelemetry, and the user is sort of free to log all of their traces from the runtime and sort of sync that into any database of their own choice. And so you can set up a runtime, and then you can sort of like select your own tracing provider, and then you can log all of the telemetry that comes out of AutoGen. Okay. They also have the idea of context management, the ability to sort of pass around context across agents. I haven't dug into exactly how this works, but one thing that that comes to mind is how well this is managed, such that it doesn't require that all of the agents sort of run in the same process. I probably will still need to sort of dig in to see like how all of this is sort of done. And then finally, they have a section on orchestrating multiple agents, but for the most part, it's mostly just using while loops. And so, for example, in the example of, let's say, using an LLM as a judge, essentially they have like a while true, and they just call several agents in a loop. No real orchestration here, actually. So overall, there are a few things that the OpenAI Agent SDK does really well. So for example, I like the clean, clear abstractions for agents, the name, instructions, the system message. I like the abstractions for tools and guardrails, and also the nice, clean upfront story for tracing. However, there are a few things that are missing. And so typically when we build multi-agent applications, we not only just define the agents, we also want to define the orchestration or the flow of control across each of them. And it's typically helpful for a framework to sort of provide some presets to support that. So for example, in AutoGen, we have the idea of a selector group chat team, where like an LLM sort of at each point determines the next agent that will sort of interact or sort of take a turn. There's a concept of a swarm team, very similar to the handoffs design we saw in the OpenAI Agentic OpenAI Agents SDK. There's the idea of Magentic One, which is like a kind of a metacognition pattern. And so there's an actual orchestrator that comes up with a plan, delegates tasks to agents, and sort of coordinates, monitors the progress of task until the task is done. In addition to that, I think this SDK just doesn't have the ability to do useful things like save and load state, the ability to sort of serialize agents into declarative specifications. And then similarly, there's still not any support for low code or no code tooling like AutoGen Studio. And it's still very, very early, but I think for now, I think AutoGen is still a superset of mostly what the OpenAI SDK can do. And it's exciting to see how all of these frameworks sort of converge as we all learn about the best way or the right way to sort of build multi-agent applications. Okay, so I hope you found this video helpful. All of the code that I have shown, especially comparison between the Hello World code, can be seen on the multi-agent book website. So if you go to multiagentbook.com and you went to labs and multi-agent samples, you can go to the Hello World piece. And here I have an implementation of the Hello World app in the AutoGen Agent Chat API, the high-level API for AutoGen. An implementation of the low-level core API, and then an example of the same thing in line graph, and also the same thing in OpenAI Agents SDK. And you can compare them. And so, for example, if we're going to compare the OpenAI Agents SDK with the AutoGen Agent Chat API, we can look at things like lines of code. And even when we look at results, I think we can also look at how long it took to run for each of these examples. Okay, so that brings me to the end of this video. I did enjoy sort of getting to sort of understand what the OpenAI SDK was all about. And as a contributor to AutoGen, it was sort of interesting to see all the similarities between both of these frameworks. And I'm curious to know, like, what do you guys think about the OpenAI Agent SDK? Have you used AutoGen? And what do you think about both of them? Well, that's all for now. Catch you in the next one.